This presentation is about the difference between topic, main idea, and details that are found within a paragraph. Topics can be defined as a general subject that is being explored or discussed. Usually a topic is easily recognizable because it is stated as a short phrase and not a full sentence. The topic is a broad or expansive area that needs to be limited if it is to be discussed. For instance, a topic might be bullying or even bullying within schools. Topics are so general that they can be discussed in a variety of ways. These various ways to discuss this statement help to identify it as a topic rather than a main idea. For instance, with the topic of bullying within schools, one might look at the different forms of bullying, or the steps to take to limit bullying, or it might be the reasons why school bullying is so prevalent. It might be school culture that promotes bullying as a discussion, or it might be a comparison between private and public schools and their levels of school bullying. Identification of topic is the first step in recognizing the main idea of a paragraph, since the main idea is the idea that is stated about the topic. In the previous paragraph, the topic was school bullying, but the statement made about the topic is the main idea. So school bullying takes many forms, for instance, would be a main idea statement. Notice now the discussion will be focused on only the forms of bullying found within schools. Here's a question. Which of the following choices is the topic? Is it A, certain school environments often see increased levels of bullying? Is it B, schools that have limited supervision of the playground often see increased levels of bullying? Is it C, bullying in school environments? Or is it D, schools that don't monitor hallways and bathrooms often see increased levels of bullying? Your answer should be C. It's the shortest, so that's one clue, and it's not a complete sentence. That's another clue to identify it as topic. Read the following paragraph and state what the topic is for it. Here's a four-step method to prevent your mind from wandering while reading. First, before you attempt to read anything, look over the length of the material to see whether you have time to read it all. If not, mark a spot where you intend to stop. Second, read the title and the first paragraph and predict what the reading will be about. Third, as you read, note down in the margin what each paragraph is about. And finally, use an internal dialogue of questions to help you seek the answers and an understanding of the text. So what did you come up with as a topic? If you said the topic is a four-step method to prevent wandering while reading, you would be correct. Different from the topic is the concept of main ideas. Main idea is a central thought or key idea presented about the topic. It is written as a complete sentence and limits what will be said about the topic. In this paragraph below, we see school bullying takes many forms within schools is the main idea. The topic is about school bullying, but now we're going to be discussing the forms it takes within schools. So main ideas are often placed at the beginning of a paragraph to ensure clarity of idea within a paragraph. This is especially true in textbook readings or nonfiction. The second most likely position for a stated main idea is for the last sentence, since the last sentence often sums up the idea of the paragraph. Plural words or phrases like a variety of reasons, several steps, many forms, five characteristics. Note the S on the nouns, which indicate the plural form. As well, main ideas are the broadest or most general statement within the paragraph. The plural form in the topic sentence suggests that all the other sentences are going to present more specific details. The school bullying takes many forms within schools as the main idea, and then one form is a physical intimidation, another statement of detail when it says another form. Notice how well focused this paragraph is on just discussing the form school bullying takes within schools. So try this one in terms of identifying the main idea. Read the following paragraph and state what the main idea is for the paragraph. It's the same paragraph that you read earlier for topic. Here we would write down the complete first sentence. So we would say, here's a four-step method to prevent your mind from wandering while reading. Sometimes writers only imply or suggest the main idea through the use of details. There is no one sentence within the paragraph that states the main idea. This unstated main idea is often seen when an author is wanting to build a description or create suspense. To identify the main idea, you must look at what all the details hold in common and what the details are trying to make a point about, and then create your own main idea statement. So here, this is the same paragraph again. This time it's missing the opening statement, which was the main idea statement, or known as the topic sentence. So what we would have to do is look at all these details and then come up with our own statement of main idea. So here you're given four sentences that provide a step in each sentence. Question is, what are the four steps trying to achieve? The last sentence helps us to understand that it's about understanding and maintaining focus while reading. So the main idea might be, there is a four-step method to prevent your mind from wandering while reading. Another element within the composition of a paragraph is the use of details that help to explore the main idea. Since one statement does not often provide full clarity of an idea, details are added to supplement and enhance the idea. The details must add information and be connected to the main idea or to the major details and not just the topic. Otherwise, the details are seen as repetitive or irrelevant. Details take two forms. Details that list a breakdown of elements of the main idea are known as major details and are bold in the example on the next slide. Details that provide examples of major details are known as minor details and are italicized in the example on the next slide. So here's the example. Again, back to this paragraph on school bullying. You can see the bolded ones are one form and another form. The minor details are examples of the physical intimidation and an example of emotional belittling that occurs. Signal words often suggest that details are present within the paragraph, especially when they come at the beginning of internal sentences within the paragraph. These sentences will not state the main idea, but will provide more information on the main idea. Words like one, first, for one thing, another, second, in addition, next, moreover, furthermore, last, or finally, are all signal words. So signal words can be broken down on what role they play within the paragraph. They indicate the organization pattern found within the paragraph. These signals help the reader to understand how the supporting details are exploring the main idea. Some are geared towards emphasis, what's the most important idea, what's the least important. Some are geared towards showing us time or sequence of events. Some are just additional information being added. Some signal words are showing us a cause and effect relationship. Some signal words will come and show us comparison of two ideas. Others show contrast, and some act as illustration. So here the signal words are shown to you. Again, this is another paragraph that we've looked at already. But we can see the four step is signaling to us that we should be looking for four things. And we can see the signals are first. Note how the signal words help guide the reader through the discussion. They clearly mark the four steps, and details follow right after the signal in the very same sentence. There are other methods that also signal details are forthcoming. One method is the use of bullets, or lettering, or numbering. So down below, the ideas are being numbered. In this example, the repetition of the word form is giving us a signal that these are the details that we want to take note of. Some signal words will alter according to the context. For example, first may mean the first in a sequence of events, and so it will work as a time signal. However, first might be used to show the first in a number of details that support the main idea, and therefore it's being used as an addition signal. Topic, main idea, and details are the essential elements within any type of paragraph. Furthermore, paragraphs are the building blocks of any form of written composition, such as essays, research papers, sermons, and speeches. Therefore, it is essential to be able to identify these elements to improve your reading comprehension and your written responses. This is especially true as you encounter more difficult reading material and more demanding written responses in your post-secondary studies.